Honda's IndyCar stars returning to action at the high-speed, high-drama Texas Motor Speedway this weekend. Morning showers delayed the practice session, but once the HPD power hit the track, speeds were lightning quick. Scott Dixon with the fastest rip in practice, topping 223 miles per hour. It was Honda stars occupying the top five spots on the practice speed charts on the newly repaved Texas track that also featured a little less banking through turns one and two. Sporting new headgear promoting Kevin Hart's book, I Can't Make This Stuff Up, Life Lessons, Marco Andretti also in the top five in the early session. Marco, the first runner out during qualifying, learned the lesson of how fine a line it is between getting it right and being a little off.
Yeah, lap two was good, lap one was bad, so the average isn't very good.
Just like the practice session, it was Honda power showing the way during the balance of the qualifying. Track conditions improved with each participant that took to the 1.5 mile oval. Scott Dixon would make his attempt later in the session and post a new fast time.
Yeah, we got some serious power, I think, from the Honda. But, you know, it's Texas. It's not going to matter too much where you start. I think if you've got a good race car, you're going to find your way to the front. And it's definitely a long race here. It's going to be interesting, I think, with tire degradation as it's a new track and a lot of new things for us here this weekend.
Tristian Vautier makes his return to Dale Coyne Racing this weekend, subbing for injured Sebastien Bourdais. And he turned plenty of heads with his qualifying laps. The Frenchman will start the race Saturday night from the fifth spot. Vautier said he owes all the credit to the team.
It's really thanks to the team, because from this morning when I jumped in, the car felt really good, so it really helped me get back up to speed. To be honest, I was a bit nervous to see how it was going to feel. I was still recovering, we all think about him, and I have big shoes to fill this weekend.
Alexander Rossi conferred with fellow Indy 500 winner Takuma Sato before his run and was the quickest of the HPD-powered Andretti cars. He'll start third under the lights on Saturday. Rossi likes the starting spot and looks forward to an exciting race.
You know, third is good, and as we saw last year, a lot can happen at this race, so I feel really good in our race car as well, and just confidence is high at the moment.
Nearing the end of qualifying, Charlie Kimball in his number 83 Ganassi machine went out and posted two lightning-quick laps on the new surface to blow away the track record. Kimball's two-lap average speed was 222.556 miles per hour, earning him his first career pole, and boy, was he happy about it.
Oh, it's fantastic. I mean, it was... We knew we had a good car coming in here. Scott showed really well at the test in April in the 83 car, and you know, everyone at Chip Ganassi Racing's worked really hard to make sure that this is what we do. We qualify on pole, we put ourselves in a position to go lead the race and win the race. You know, the Honda power was everything we needed. I think, you know, I looked at one point and it was, at least in practice, the top six or seven cars Honda powered. So that bodes well for us being able to ride off into the distance tomorrow night.
With it being the first pole for the team, they were a little unsure of where the P1 sticker was to be installed. After some tough times this season, Kimball is also hoping this turns his season in the right direction.
Yeah, I like to say if we haven't had bad luck, we've had no luck. So hopefully this bodes well for the race tomorrow night. And while you get a point for pole, there's 50 points on offer tomorrow. So we're focused on that.
Honda has the field covered at Texas. When the green flag waves for the race Saturday night, the top eight qualifiers will be powered by Honda. From the Texas Motor Speedway, I'm Todd Lewis, Honda Racing HPD Trackside.